The next question from Munira Akhtar Moni from Bangladesh. Is it compulsory for a woman to cover her feet during Salah? The question asked is that is it compulsory for a woman to cover her feet while offering Salah? As far as this question is concerned, there's a difference of opinion. But the majority of the fuqaha, the majority of the scholars, they say that during Salah, it is compulsory for a woman to cover her feet. And according to the Shafi school of thought, as well as the Maliki school of thought, and as well as the Hanbali school of thought, most of the scholars in the Hanbali school of fiqh, they say that covering the feet is compulsory. Based on the hadith of Sunan Abu Dawud, volume number 1, hadith number 640, that Umm Salma, may Allah be pleased with her, radiallahu anha, she said that when she asked the Prophet that can a woman wear only her khimar and her kameez and offer salah without wearing the izar? So the Prophet, he replied, khimar is the head covering and kameez is a long dress. So if a woman is only wearing the khimar and the kameez and not wearing the izar, will a salah be accepted? And the Prophet replied that if the kameez is as long as till the top of the feet, then the salah is accepted. So based on this hadith, the Shafi school of thought, the Maliki school of thought, as well as the Hanbali school of thought, the most of the scholars, they say that covering of the feet is compulsory. But according to the Hanafi school of thought, and as well as the view of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, as well as the view of Muhammad Saleh Ibn Utaymiyyah, may Allah be pleased with them both. May Allah have mercy on them both. Their view is that it is not compulsory for the woman to cover the feet during Salah. And they say that this hadith of Abu Dawud, volume number 1, hadith number 640 of Abu Dawud, it's a daif hadith. There are various other hadith talking about the same aspect that the Prophet said, that, I mean, the same aspect that it is, that the kameez should be up to the top of the feet. But all these hadith, they are not marfu. They don't go up to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. All these hadith, they are mawquf. That means the sahaba, they quoted Umm Salma radiallahu anha, the wife of the Prophet. But nowhere does it go up to the Prophet. The hadith of Abu Dawud which goes to the Prophet, it is a daif hadith. And all the other hadith is only reaching up to Umm Salma. May Allah be pleased with her. So that is the reason they say that it is not going up to the Prophet. And the argument that Ibn Taymiyyah gives is that at the time of the Prophet, the ladies in their home, they used to wear a kameez, a long gown, and the feet were seen. And they used to offer salah in the same kameez. So based on that, he says that the aura for the woman is the complete body except the face, the hands up to the wrist and the feet. So according to the Hanafi school of thought and Ibn Taymiyyah and Ibn Utaymi, they say that the aura of the woman is the complete body except the face, the hands up to the wrist and the feet. As far as the Shafi school of thought is concerned and the Maliki school of thought and the Hanbali school of thought, the aura, the feet also comes in the aura. That is the reason in Salah you have to cover it. There's a difference of opinion, and I've given you the opinion of both the group of scholars, but the majority of the fuqaha, they are of the view that the feet comes in the aura and it should be covered during Salah, except for the Hanafi scholars. And we know that the Hanafis in the world, they are approximately 50% of the Muslim Ummah in the Ahl-e-Sunnah wal Jamaat, they are Hanafis. And even according to Ibn Taymiyyah and Ibn Uthaymeen, it is not fard, it's not compulsory to cover the feet for the woman during Salah.